took the cake, but still, he was a committed actor and he did a great job. But Boris Colin. Oh, why hello there, and welcome back to Monster Month with me, Frankenstein. And today's video, well, today's review, I am reviewing the 1931 classic original, Frankenstein, based on the book by Mary Shelley, directed by James Whale, starring Colin Clive, me, Clark, John Blow, Boris Karloff, of course, Dwight Frayne, Edward Van Solem, and Frederick Kerr. So, as I said, this is based on Mary Shelley's book of the same name novel, where Henry Frankenstein, for some reason I don't know why it's called Victor, copyright stuff, I don't know, digs up bodies and creates his infamous creation, the monster, played by the legendary Boris Karloff. So, and he rejects the creature because he realizes he is played God. So, what did I like and what didn't I like about this film? Well, first of all, I liked it. It was a great film, a classic. And it was probably one of the early horror films with sound. Of course, the 1931 Dracula takes that title for the first horror movie with sound. And yeah, I liked the cinematography and the effects that were used. Like I say, very limited in the 30s with visual effects. But of course, I can't forget that makeup Boris Karloff wears. Now, he looks visually brilliant. He created the modern trope of how Frankenstein's monster is looked and portrayed, and that look has gone on to be featured in The Munsters and other Frankenstein materials. I also liked, and Boris Karloff, I liked his performance as well as the monster. And of course, there was a lot of trouble with Boris on the set of that film. He would sit for hours and hours and hours a day in that makeup in the hot California sun, and he would, you know, he would suffer in there in all that makeup, extremely hot. And of course, back then the actors got no say, they had to do their acting job, or else they wouldn't get paid at all, and they'd replace them like that. So that was another thing that they, you know, but still, Boris fought on and delivered a brilliant performance. Just a shame actors weren't treated brilliantly back then. And Boris really took the cake, but still, he was a committed actor and he did a great job. But Boris Karloff did many films before this one, and you know, it was this movie that actually made him an overnight success. You know, if you don't try, if you don't succeed first, then try and try again. And my God, Boris, you made yourself an icon in movie history. But yeah, I love the creation in it. There's also a scene in there that was very controversial, where the monster throws a little girl in the pond, which Probably by today's standards, it's not that big a deal, but in 1931 it was a big deal and they cut that bit out, and it would be 30 years before they added again. Also, I believe that this might have been an R rating and very scary in the 30s, but today it's like a PG film, and you know, is an important part of horror cinema as well, this movie. Of course, I can't forget the other actors like Colin, Clive as Frankenstein, and Igor, and that iconic line he goes with saying, "It's alive, my God, it's alive!" Yeah, it's just brilliant. Of course, I don't think it's in its original setting. I'd say it's set in the 30s, where it was made, because, well, the monster dresses in a black suit, and so does Frankenstein and all that. But then there's the villagers and stuff. I don't know. I don't know if this film has a timestamp or anything on it. All I know is that this is an enjoyable film. It's about 71 minutes long, but doesn't feel like that. It doesn't feel short and it doesn't feel long. It's just an entertaining horror masterpiece and has, you know, become immortal. This has made Boris Karloff immortal, and I can see why. This is a great film, and James Whale as well did great job directing. In fact, he went on to direct the sequels as well and became good friends with Karloff. And, you know, James Whale, he never had an easy life, of course, but, you know, he still delivered great work in what he did, especially with directing. So, yeah, this is just a great film, and I can't say how great more it is. You know, it's black and white, but who cares? It's just a great film. My negatives, I don't think I have any. So let's just get on with my ratings. I'm going to give Frankenstein from 1931 5 out of 5. So there we go. That's my review for Frankenstein 1931. So that's it for this one. So join me next time where I'll review another monster horror for you all. And yeah, so I've been Frankenstein. Have you seen this one, Frankenstein? Let me know down in the comments below. And if you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up, share with your friends, and feel free to subscribe to the official Random Horror YouTube channel, and to share with your friends and to hit that bell. So until next time, don't have nightmares.